everybody! Welcome back to Northern Lion Plays, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Let's do this. New run, not continue. I was playing a little bit off camera. Not to finish your run, just to check some stuff out. Who are we going to play as this time? We can either play Blue Baby or Eve. Blue Baby or Eve. Or maybe Maggie and try to take, like, that boss rush and lamb path, but... Or Eden and take the... Eden could be fun, but we've done that a little too much recently, I think. Let's play as Eve. I think it's been a while since we played as Eve, and my gut tells me that Eve is like one of my least favorite characters. Let's look at our seed here. 6C 0 K 0 X 77. Okay, there you go. My gut tells me that Eve is like my least favorite character, so I'm gonna try to knock out her bullshit right away. On the bright side, even though we can't access that red chest, I think. Maybe we could have walked into the fire, but I don't really love that idea. On the bright side, we did get Whore of Babylon activated, so I'm really hoping for a strong start. The worst thing that can happen with Eve, and it happens frequently, unfortunately, is not getting like a tears or a damage upgrade early, first couple of floors, or a great deal with the devil on the second floor, and then you just kind of get snowballed behind. Like, you start, especially if you get like a tears down pill or something like that, you do no damage. That ruins your chances to get deals with the devil in the future. Thereby, you never start to do more damage unless you get exceptionally lucky and you get, like, bailed out on an item room or something like that. Sure. Spider Babby. I know it's Spider Baby. I kind of like that it's Spider Babby, you know? How was Babby formed? All that. Classic internet may-may, sir. We're gonna move on here. I'm not gonna take this pill because I am concerned. Oh, that's a sweet bomb opportunity there. I'm not gonna take this pill because I'm concerned that we're gonna get that exact prophecy. We're gonna get like a tears downgrade or something like that, and I'm gonna be scared poopless. Well, it's a new record. We ended up not fighting Monstro on the second floor, at least not fighting him in his pure boss form. I did take a little damage there, not proud about that. I was very happy to get that spirit heart, and I hope we can have it continue. I really feel like as Eve, it's almost preferable. At least it feels nicer to just have permanent Whore of Babylon active constantly. Like, I don't even want to improve our HP. If we get an HP upgrade, like this one, then what can I do about it? I might as well go back to full health then. But if I can keep Whore of Babylon activated, I would rather do that. Finally, that is perfect drinking temperature on that coffee. I've been waiting to record until the coffee was ready, which is like the worst reason to not be productive. Drankins, why haven't you done any work this morning? It's 1:11 p.m. Well, sir, I was waiting for the coffee to cool down. You're fucking fired. Okay. That's fair. Luckily, I'm my own boss, so all I have to answer to is my real boss, my wife. Seriously, though, don't tell her I said that. Okay. Item room. Good item room on this floor. Should be shooting the poop. Don't get me wrong. I know. Shooting the poop is just, it's what you do. Something you gotta be doing in order to get the amount of money that you need to succeed. You know, you also, you can use two tea bags more than once, you know? Save 10 cents every cup of tea you have. That's actually pretty nice. We're not gonna take that just yet, but... Okay, well, multiple of the same pill here. What did I fudgin' tell you? Oh my god. I just had a strong feeling that that would be a tears downgrade because that's like the recipe for disaster as Eve, and wouldn't you know it, there you go. When what do we get? We got magic scab. So magic scab isn't even like a tears upgrade or a damage upgrade. It's HP plus luck. Thanks for the good luck, magic scab. If we wanted to, there's actually three tiers downgrades. So if we wanted to shoot zero shots per millennia, we could give that a try. For now, though, I'm a little salty, but at least our HP is a little higher, and we should have a deal with the devil approaching now. $3 bill, also a pretty good item. If we can get things like scythes, then I don't need to worry about our tiers that much because one tier will destroy every enemy that we come across. But we also have things like my reflection, which is working right now to just make me sad about my life. I'm a little concerned. I've got to be real with you here. We gotta get out of this room without getting hit. Oh my god, each one of these guys takes 55 shots to kill. We gotta get out of this room without getting hit. And if we can get to that tinted rock, that tinted rock holds the secrets of the ooze here. Because if that contains a spirit heart, which it does, life is good. If it didn't, we would have to beat Larry Jr.'s here without taking damage, which is not unlikely. Wow, that was a pretty good bomb. Not unlikely, I'll admit, but maybe not the most likely. And this should guarantee us a deal with the devil now, and it's all worked out. Let's just hope that we can get... Oh, we have a lucky tough love here. Let's hope that we can get a good devil room, because, you know, latchkey isn't really what I was looking for there. All right, I will take ceremonial robes. Doesn't really do much for us offensively. Oh, snap. Yeah, now I will definitely take Guppy's hairball, and I will take nine lives as well for free. So now we're only one Guppy item away from actual success in becoming Guppy. And I know people are occasionally... First off, let's just nip this shit in the bud. The second order, Northern Lion, don't get mad at people getting mad at you. I'm getting mad because you're getting mad at people getting mad at you. Look, we've crossed the point into fucking absurdity here, okay? Let's just all be cool. Let me say my piece here and then we'll move on and not dwell on it. I know there's going to be people who are going to be ornery that were potentially becoming Guppy here. They're going to say, Northern Lion, you've become Guppy a lot recently. Don't you think it's too easy to become Guppy in Rebirth? I'm still, the jury for me is still out on that question. And you might be saying that's convenient, you know, logic, but like, for all the times that I've become Guppy, there have been like, especially recently, there's been a lot of times that it succeeded, but there's been a lot of times if you go back between like episode 15 and this one, there's been a lot of times where it just straight up failed. Like I tried to become Guppy and it just didn't work out. We're gonna leave it even without going to the shop. So no, I don't know that it's too easy to become Guppy. I do think that it seems to, and this is very unscientific, but it seems to come in fits and spurts. There will be times when becoming Guppy is obvious and easy, and there are times when it'll seem obvious and easy and you just won't get it. Either way, considering this is a run where I very much would like to succeed, I'm going to continue. By the way, I did have a bit... We have, like, proptosis here. I did have a bit of a quandary over whether or not to pick up that Eternal Heart. Because I was really loving the fact that we had Permanent Whore of Babylon. Oh, that's pretty sweet, actually. But yeah, I was loving the fact that we had Permanent Whore of Babylon. Which gave me the actual ability to deal damage. Which is something that we're still struggling with, even though it might look like our run is amazing. You know, neither Guppy's Hairball nor Ceremonial Robes nor Nine Lives really give us a lot of offensive punch right away. The potential is there in the future, but the punch is not there just yet. $3 bill gives us a little bit, but, you know, you can see, look at our tiny little puny micro tiers here. Not doing anything there. Okay, prayer card is beautiful, but also kind of runs against what I was saying earlier, where I want to get to the point where I can actually... Oh man, we can just get an HP upgrade immediately here. I think it's worth it, just so that we can get another prayer card stored up by the end of the floor. But yeah, you know, we want to get to the point where we can actually have Whore of Babylon active. The other way out of it is that we just get to the point where we don't need Whore of Babylon because our damage is fine as is. But we're going to need deals with the devil for that, which is, you know, a little bit more of a crapshoot. Traded a bomb for a bomb there. Actually, kind of like this situation... Because if the explosions happen, maybe they could get a mushroom in it, and maybe that could give me a pill. Sure, broken magnet. It kind of works. As for the rest of the items in the shop, I'm not totally sure, you know? I could buy Mom's Purse. I could buy BOGO Bombs. I think I'd be happy with either of those. But sincerely, I don't really see too much impetus immediately for buying either of them. I don't love this. I don't love this very much at all. Once you learn to swing Guppy's hairball, you can do a little bit of extra damage with it, but usually it's against damage that are or against enemies that are not very mobile in their own right. And Gertie Jr., pretty mobile in its own right. By the way, what did we even get as our tier effect for this room? Is it like my reflection or something like that? Because it's not really, I'm not really loving it. I'm not saying I need to have the scythes on every room, $3 bill. I would appreciate it, but I'm not saying I need it, but... At least, like, a toxic aura or something like that. Alright, we're gonna do fine here. If we are gonna get a deal with the devil, we did our best to get the odds of it, and we got a speed upgrade. Let's continue exploring here. Definitely, you know, curse rooms... See, 2020 would have been amazing as well. By the way, I apologize for not taking 2020 in that boss rush room a few episodes ago, or probably like a few days ago at this point. I didn't know what the icon for 2020 was. I just saw the glasses, and I'm like, I don't know, that shit could be anything. Now I know. I had it on like an off-camera run. And I... Oh, the mark is super good. That saves us a whole hell of a lot of trouble. That extra damage is pretty important. We got triple shot here. Gertie's still not dying super quickly, but... Our tiers downgrade is mitigated a lot by that mark card. That helps us out a great deal. Now, there's no reason for us, logically at least, to use the prayer card yet. We'll use it just before the end of the floor, which is actually, you know, coming up right now. How does Guppy's hairball work again? Like, if you don't take damage, it grows larger, thereby making it easier to swing? Like that? Oh man, we're rolling in HP now. Pretty Fly is pretty good as well. Strangely enough, I don't really want to be rolling in HP, but I'll take it, I guess. Take a quick look for our secret room. There you go. Would I rather have BOGO bombs? Whoa, that's pretty nice. Well, we kind of got a happy medium here. We got Bomb Bag, which is okay. Kind of fell out of favor at the end of Vanilla because of, you know, items like the Miter and the Relic. Bomb Bag made them worse. I'll tell you what, let's take, we'll take Mom's Purse here. We don't really have two good trinkets yet, but if we get two good trinkets, we can take it with them. Take them, you know, we can accompany them on their voyage downwards. To put it in a less awkward way, apparently. HP's through the roof. Good run so far, but I'm really looking for that killer damage item. Pact is a start, but it's not going to carry us the whole way. And remember, I'm still going through this kind of existential pseudo-crisis type thing here, where I'm like, I don't really know that items like the prayer card... Ooh, that's not very good for us right now, but maybe in the future. Where I don't really think that items like the prayer card are as useful as they originally seem. Because... I just don't know. Because they reduce the ability to hold other kinds of hearts. Because of the HP cap. So I don't know, there's gotta be some kind of, like, new balance in the meta now. That I'm not totally familiar with. Or I haven't really sussed out for myself. Like, would it be better to have 12 red hearts, which we can totally get with the prayer card, or 10 red hearts, 2 black hearts? I think it depends where you're at in the game. I think the later into the game that you are, the more you'd rather prefer to have things like black hearts. Or even, you know, spirit hearts. Depending on what items you've got going on. But anyway, Tammy's head, if we end up leaving it behind, I'm not going to love leaving it behind, but at the same time, it's not going to be a run-sundering decision, unless we end up getting brimstone or something like that. Tammy's head plus brimstone would be a no-brainer choice, and we may have that opportunity approaching us here. Gimpy is a pretty okay item. It doesn't pay out as much as I'd like if you're not familiar with what it does. If you get hit, it gives you a chance to drop a spirit heart, which on the surface is pretty good, kind of like a weird dark bum but in reverse type situation. However, it has a very low rate of actually effectively paying out. Which is good, because it balances it, whereas Dark Bomb is out of control good. But is bad, because it's not super amazing. But it's still okay. I'll be happy to have it for free. I don't know why we're getting so many Spirit Heart drops, but I guess I shouldn't be one to complain. Just trying to get some easy swings of Guppy's Hairball in here. You can get some real velocity going on it if you're brave, if you don't back out at the last second, you know? Yeah, like that was stupid. On my part, I just shouldn't have walked into that. Lemon Party. Actually a pretty good pill. Oh my god. Why am I trying to use Guppy's Hairball like I'm some kind of super Guppy's Hairball pro? Shoot it into a bomb fly. Yeah, that's going to work out well. If anything, I should be trying to keep it away from the bomb flies. But hey, we found a secret room. As a result of that one. Lucky me. 2 extra bombs. Okay. Many, many extra bombs. Now if we could, just get some bomb synergies. I love that you don't have to use bombs to reopen secret rooms after I make a dumb mistake like that. I suppose we probably should have been using the prayer card a little bit more often. In the end, it probably won't end up mattering, but... Yeah, I could see that actually being useful. Like, we probably could have gotten 2 on this floor. Like, 2, Oh, but it only really matters if you get 3, so I guess it's not really that big of a deal. Alright, so... You know the deal. I think Mega Fatty, I used to think he was far too easy. Now, I think he's actually, like, fairly well balanced. Maybe even a little bit more difficult than your average boss here, just because he's so tanky, but... Well, we're not going to have the opportunity to get Brimstone here. You'll have to excuse the loud rumbling. There's a man on a motorcycle outside. He's got a huge cock. That's why I needed an engine that big. Every time I say that, let me sip my coffee here before this rant. Let's take the pill. All right. I mean, yeah, we might as well try it now, right? Should have used it earlier, but I didn't know it was 48-hour energy, so... Every time I say that, there's people, and they come into the comments, and they say, Northern Lion, the reason motorcycles are loud is because, well, among other reasons, but one of the reasons motorcycles are loud is so that cars can hear them and makes them more safe to ride. Can I just say that you are totally fucking right? Like, you're straight up in the right there. Okay, one second. I've received a message on Skype that has chosen to slow down the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. I think it's gaining some speed. You're gonna have to give it a second here. The ultimate irony would be if this was from Tyrone or something like that. Who we got here? Sign out, please. Rebirth has this weird thing where it just, it was not from Tyrone, by the way. Rebirth has this weird thing where it just, with some applications, it just does not play nice. On the whole, it runs so much better than vanilla, or Flash Isaac. But just to cut, like, if I get a message in-game in Steam, it's just like, we're gonna go down to, like, 0 frames per second. Sorry for the trouble. But yeah, on the motorcycle thing, they're loud for the, you know, so that cars hear them and are less likely to, you know, run them off the road accidentally. You're totally right. At the same time, just let me be annoyed. I live on, like, apparently a street where it's actually probably not as bad as it seems, but probably, like, 15 times a day, a really loud motorcycle goes by really quickly. And it disturbs me the slightest bit. And if I may, I think that the people kind of want me to be disturbed a little bit. You know, I watch the people that go by sometimes. I'm a people watcher because I'm 100 fucking years old and I want to make sure no one's stealing my strawberries out of my garden. And, you know, they got like the racing leathers on and I picture them like that dude from that reality show. We'll fight Sloth here. But that dude from that reality show where he's like, I'm the biggest, baddest motorcycler on the planet. No judge can get me. And then it's like traffic court or something. I don't think it lasted too long on the air. But then he like winks at the judge and he's like trying to flirt with her because she's, you know, relatively young as far as judges go, I guess. And then she gives him a ticket. And when he tries to drive away at the end, he does a wheelie and he falls off his motorcycle. And that's super not fair, though. That's my own prejudice on display there, very much on display there. But at the same time, just let me be annoyed. That's the dynamic, right? If you're a motorcyclist, you need someone to be mad at. And as a non-motorcyclist, I need someone to be mad at, too. Let's hope we fight greed here. Really hoped that we'd fight greed there. Like, that's the whole... It's not really counterculture if the culture just accepts you, right? I'm just gonna take that. So let me be the culture, and you can be the counterculture. I'll be annoyed, and you'll make loud noises, and then in the end, we'll have a realization that that's kind of like the homeostatic mechanism by which society works. Let's head down to the next floor. Now, on this floor, we should, in theory, be able to get three, if we're lucky at least, we should be able to get three prayer card charges, is my thinking. Now, how do I feel about this run thus far? It's good. Whether or not it's good enough, definitely is still something that's up in the air. Our damage is still shit. Like, even with the mark, it's just the mark. And Cat of Nine Tails, right? We have the mark and Cat of Nine Tails. That's not going to carry you through an Isaac fight. That'll carry you through a mom fight. But we need definitely at least a couple more good things or one more amazing thing. If we got Mom's Knife, Brimstone, a Guppy Transformation, those would be a good start. That's another pretty fly? Lemon Party. I really like the Lemon Party card, I gotta admit. I will not complain about this, especially if we have a land-based boss. Like, you saw how it dismantled Mega Fatty. There are people who will disagree with me, by the way. But I really feel in Rebirth, especially, because... Basically, what has changed the difficulty in Rebirth? Those fucking nubs that pop up from the ground is one, but, Wheel of Fortune. The other one is big rooms. So, like, big rooms on the chest, I think, are the hardest rooms that you can come across in the entire game. We didn't have big rooms on the chest before, and previously in Vanilla Isaac, you didn't necessarily need to be OP to beat the chest. Not gonna take that. But you needed to be pretty effing solid. Like, even a good player can lose before the chest... If they don't have at least an above average run in terms of strength. Above average on the whole, not for them personally. But anyway, I really feel that, I mean, we're still very early days here in Rebirth, but I feel like it's gotten harder to beat the chest. You know, more unpredictable enemy patterns, at least for now. So you really, I don't really like anemia or anemic too much. When you get hit, you basically make creep. It's okay, I guess, you know, it's sort of like bit of a shittier poison touch, maybe, but yeah, I really feel like you have to almost be OP to win. Which I don't think is a problem. I think that's just the way the game is. But we're definitely like a little bit away from being at the threshold for what I would consider to be a win here. At least a guaranteed win. So I'm disappointed that we're fighting Greed, although the good news about this is that it makes it almost 100% certainty that we won't fight Greed on our next floor, meaning we can actually donate some of our spare money if we have it. Plus, hey, Steam sale. Alright, so we'll activate that. And it would be a damn shame if I were not able to, get a good assortment, a smattering, if you will, of deals with the devil. Because we have so much HP, I don't want 7 red hearts. You know, because of the HP cap and the way that HP tends to go with maybe a little bit more of a liberal balance of blue hearts and black hearts now. Couldn't this have just come one room later? Not that I should complain about getting the scythes ever, I guess. But anyway, we really don't need 7 HP. Like, 7 HP almost feels prohibitive. Like, this is too much. I feel uncomfortable having this much HP. Gotta say, I'm digging the Lemon Party versus Monstro 2. It worked pretty well. Not that Monstro 2 is difficult to begin with, but it really is one of my favorite pills. I would almost take a Lemon Party pill over, like a High Priestess card or something like that. Depending on the boss you're fighting. If the boss is like Mom's Heart and flies, well, you're not going to get too much value out of it, I guess. Deal with the devil? Yeah, okay, and pills. Well, at least we got Mom's Contact for the fight here. Get your freeze on. Doop, boop, 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 boop. Get your freeze on. I can't go anywhere after that Missy Elliott joke. I'm sorry. I don't really care what we get here. But if we get Krampus's head, which we didn't, if we had gotten Krampus's head, I would have replaced Prayer Card with it. I think Prayer Card is... It's coming to the point where it's going to wear out its welcome, you know? At some point, it's just not useful anymore. Okay, 48-hour energy is awesome. Oh, man, not a good... Well, Bad Trip actually worked out fine for us there. So what I'm thinking is we go to, like, 2 more rooms, get it charged, and then use 48-hour energy and maybe get, like, 3 HP out of this. Well, 2 HP, but still. And again, I'm starting to wish that maybe we'd gone with Tammy's head. We'll take this instead of Broken Magnet. But I don't think you can really blame me for the decisions I've made with respect to the prayer card. You know, it's nice to have the HP. That's a tiers downgrade. And once we get to 12 HP, then we can replace... We can replace a prayer card with whatever the fuck we want. Just... No, 2. Fairly easy. So we'll use that. Then we'll use 48-hour energy. And we'll use that. So that's 1 pure HP right there. And then we'll use it again. And we may, but probably won't be able to get 1 more HP by the end of this floor. But still, certainly, like, prayer card 48-hour energy is a dumb synergy. And I mean dumb in the most polite way possible, but it is so overpowered. But, you know, that's, again, I kind of resent the use of OP in Rebirth thus far, because I think you gotta be OP to do some of the stuff the game asks of you. And this is even only on normal mode. I haven't even touched hard mode yet. I don't know if I will at some point. I don't know if I'll play it reliably. I've heard that it's like a seriously nightmarish kind of experience. Bad Trip. I mean, actually, you know what? The Bad Trip pill is a lot better than Wheel of Fortune. Maybe I'd feel... You know what? I wouldn't even feel differently on the chest because... Bad Trip... would give us full health. Whereas the Wheel of Fortune would just give us an item. But the item could give us full health, but yeah, sure. You know, lots of items could give us lots of things. Or lots of pills could give us lots of things. I feel like we should look for pills here. We have 49 bombs. What if we find, like, a 48-hour energy pill? Pretty Fly is great, and you know what? Mini Mush is fine as well. I am happy with both of those. So I'm really, really hoping that we get a deal with the devil on the next floor, and that the deal with the devil gives... Oh, we fought Greed in there, right. And the deal with the devil gives us damage upgrades. A tears upgrade from the boss would go a long way as well. We were actually, like, dangerously close. Oh. Ugh. Well, we got Mini Mush. We were dangerously close to getting, like, another HP upgrade there. Oh, it wouldn't have even been another HP upgrade. It would have just finalized that one. Okay. Point taken. Let's try to get our way to our item room first. We have a boss trap room here, first of all. We're not gonna be able to access it. There might be an arcade or something, though. Haven't really made good use of the arcades thus far. I gotta check something here. Pull the music up just a little bit. I've had it low because it gets just a little bit. He triples it anyway. I've had the music down pretty low because it gets loud on the chest and the cathedral and even the womb. Maybe I'll set it at 2 permanently. Where are you going here, Hans? Oh. Any minute now. There we go. Seriously? Thanks to our tiers downgrade, like, if I have triple shot as my effect for a room, I just can't do shit. Like, I basically can only fire, like, twice per room. Yeah, I wasn't a big fan of that one. Kill these as soon as possible, please. This item room is big. Please be good offensively. I'll take it. We have high range, and I've been complaining about damage. That's the recipe for making Bob's brain work for you. Bob's brain can be good, can be bad, but I have a if nothing else, a respect for Bob's brain. Even though it's not the optimal time to take that, I'm going to do so. And I'm going to get the curse immunity as well. And if we have more money, we'll probably end up donating it. I think Black Candle's okay for that. But I have, if nothing else, a high level of respect for Bob's brain. Ever since that run, where basically it allowed us to beat Mega Satan on the first try. I did not expect that, but yeah, if we play our cards right, especially if we get the ability to fly, Bob's brain, very nice for us. Sure, it will cost us some HP. Almost certainly. That's okay. Gotta learn to deal with it. Because I think Bob's brain is one of those items. It's almost like... You know what? I think the commenter was more right than I gave them credit for when they said this and I brought it up. Yeah, we'll open these. I was real hoping for a Guppy item there. Is that Able? Man, that's not so good. Like, the least... my least favorite item I could get from a situation like that. But anyway. Yeah, no boss rush, so the hermit card's not so valuable. When the commenter said, you know, I see Bob's brain kind of the way like I saw Ipecac back when vanilla was first out, and people were like, oh, Ipecac's not worth taking, and then it turns out, no, hold up, Ipecac is, like, super worth taking. It's just a little bit, you know, you gotta learn how to deal with it. I sort of agree with that now, although I think there are runs in which it's prudent to take, an item like Bob's Brain. Ipecac I would probably take in almost any situation unless I had Brimstone or... You know, I'd probably take it with Brimstone or Mom's Knife, but unless I had really, really amazing damage. Two of Hearts. That trip is still a little better. And I'm still going to these rooms, by the way, because I want to make sure that... Well, first off, I want to make sure I go to this curse room. But beyond that, I... We have Proptosis here, which is bad for us, but beyond that, I want to get our last, probably, prayer card activated here. We can take prayer card with us in the future. It might be better just to take the tarot cards, though. And I'm probably not going to go for the reroll room. I know I'm lazy. Reroll room is also the name of my club down, you know, West Street. West Street. But yeah, I'm probably not... Well, first off, I don't have any keys, but secondly, I even if I did, I probably wouldn't go to it just because I want to... I want to stick with what we got going on here already. It's going pretty well. Why mess with a good thing, you know? Let's take the... but we have Bad Trip. Why would we want to take tarot cards with us? Bad Trip is a full health pill. It's very useful. Guess we'll just move our way onto the boss room here. Oh, we should donate at least then. Nice. Protect that last eternal heart. So we might end up rolling with prayer card a little bit longer than I'd like, but hopefully we have the chance to replace it with something. Something soon. I know, by the way, that you have to get up to, like, 999 cents to actually make this donation machine cap out. Or get close to capping out. Maybe you can donate even more after that. So I'm trying to be a little bit more vigilant about it, but it's so tempting to just, like, borrow against it at the start of a run. So you can buy an item you otherwise shouldn't be able to afford, like the compass, like we did on this run. We've already been there. And I don't mean on vacation. Well, we can't even do anything there. We are going to be trying to go to the chest, so let's hope we get some keys in the future. Oh, Bob's Brain, you fudging blew it, buddy. You got to learn to fire a little quicker. Here we go. That's a good one. Well, Red Mom is the easiest. We don't necessarily have the greatest kind of setup for dealing with a Red Mom here. That's okay, though. 50% of the way through the fight. Guppy's Hairball, some orbitals. Those orbitals don't deal any damage, though, I think. That's pretty good. Lump of Coal. Bob's Brain's the big one. We just gotta make sure we actually hit with it. Whenever possible, at least. Ooh. Oh god, the sneeze is real. Oh, but we're almost done. Just let me sneeze! Okay. No deal with the devil. Very disappointed with that. But we're gonna be able to go, the cathedral path. And I think we've got a pretty good chance of making this work for ourselves. This floor is kind of important, though. I think it's worth it. Because we need the guppy item, basically. Ooh, I did get hit there. If we get a deal with the devil on this floor, everything can be forgiven. On this whole run thus far. If we don't get a deal with the devil on this floor, we may find ourselves just a little bit behind the eight ball damage-wise. We might not be, you know, we've got good range, okay damage, and Lump of Coal. That gives us the ability to, at least from afar, hurt enemies pretty badly. Along with $3 bill, you know, you can get lucky on some of those late game rooms or something, but I would be more comfortable in our chances for success if we could just either get a guppy item or at least some higher damage. We're done with this. We could open that golden chest, but I think we got like a sunk cost fallacy going on here where we're like, I want to open the golden chest because I already opened the other chest. And I'm like, well, it's probably not worth it. We should be smart here, though. And, you know, these could give us something good. As could these. As could these. We have plenty of bombs. I'm not sweating the losses here. As could these. Fair enough. Can't always get what you want. And in Isaac, you don't need to always get what you want. Just occasionally. Which I think is true for real life as well, you know? That song, you can't always get what you want. Instead of, you know, if you try sometimes, you just might find you get what you need. Sure, that's a good message, I guess. But how about, you know, if you get what you want maybe like 10% of the time, then you'll still be probably like doing better than the average person in the world. So just enjoy it. Since we've already taken Red Heart damage, I feel like we might as well go to our curse room. Now I did that to tell you what not to do, clearly. I think there's some hearts left in this room up here too. Yeah, a few. So I would very, very much like to not take damage on this boss fight. Like, what is wrong with my brain right now? We got a spirit heart for that. Okay, I'm a genius. That spirit heart, if I don't take damage here, never mind. Could protect me. I don't think we want to stick to that line of reasoning too long, though. I like this room because even though we got hit, we created a spider army because our spiders can't aggro on anything else. Not gonna use prayer card until we beat the boss. We'll be at full red hearts again. I don't know if that's necessarily for the best, but it'll be what it is. I'm gonna wait for Bob's Brain to be back before we go into the boss fight. It's not a big boss fight, so we know no Mr. Fred. Which, I don't know, might be good, might be bad. Actually, since we can't fly, I feel like this Gertie fight is, or Mama Gertie, I should say, is actually kind of tough. But we have Mom's contact active. We can just land that and maybe a few more Bob's Brain shots. Then we can get through this without taking damage. Could try to run up there, plant some bombs. I think it's an ill-advised idea, unless it's frozen. Oh, we did get hit. So that should sink our deal with the devil chances right at the very end there. That's super unfortunate. We got a speed plus range upgrade, and Sure. Why not? You know, because we have a bad trip, I guess having full red hearts is kind of okay because it gives us more back. More red hearts back. Oh, so this is cool. If we can, I'd like to, well, never mind. I was going to say if we can, I'd like to donate more. So our big thing here is this, oh, there is another one, okay. Our big thing here is this curse room. If we can get through the curse room, and get a guppy item, then we have nothing to worry about. If we don't, I don't necessarily think that, you know, our run is over. And I think that, like, that's obvious. It shouldn't appear to you that this is, like, either guppy or bust right now. But it's certainly gonna be a lot harder if we don't get that, okay? If we don't get that guppy item. Or some kind of damage increase somewhere down the road. Because we're really at the mercy of Bob's brain and $3 bill. Which are two items that I'd rather not be at the mercy of, if possible. One that hurts us oftentimes, and one that, is kind of dictated by random chance. Not my favorites. Three red chests in this room could be so good. I would love to access the boss trap room as well. You know, you can get guppy items on there fairly easily, too. Oh. Oh! No. Oh, come on. It's a disappointment, to say the least. Yeah, we'll leave. Oh, man. Well, this appears to be the right way, at least. Tell you what, we'll do it like this. Let's see if this still works. Oh, they were already dead. Okay. Well, one bomb for this room is a smart play, I think. That was a pretty nice Bob's brain right there. Probably should have taken damage there. We actually do get, like, a really nice bonus from Lump of Coal. I should be trying to use it a little more often. Any more of these weird rocks around that I can take advantage of? They have a really good rate of paying out. Oh, I hate myself. So, we could try to go to the boss. You know, let's see if we can bomb our way into it. Desperate times call for desperate measures, right? Let's try if, that time, I swear to you, I didn't even walk up. My momentum carried me in. I wanted to check up here just to see if maybe we could bomb our way up this way. But truth be told, it looks like this might be the right decision just through pure luck. We'll get a really good chance. Well, we'll get a guarantee to get HP, but maybe the HP upgrade that would give us full HP? No, that's actually fine, though. Genuinely. Okay! Here's an out. So you're saying there's a chance. Red chess here. Vindicate me. Oh, you fucker. Oh my god, okay. I give up. I think my spiders are like pushing me into it somehow. I swear to you my hands weren't even on the keys there. So this bad trip pill, it's really only valuable if we can wait to use it for a little while. If we have to use it right away or nearly right away, it's not worth nearly as much. What was that Bob's brain shot? Did you see that? That one was amazing. I was not even shooting at that enemy, but it worked. Prayer card is kind of meaningless for us right now. Let's do it. Probably should have waited for Bob's brain to be active, I guess. We're gonna take some damage here. Look, it's important to set realistic expectations. I expect to be using Bad Trip on this fight or soon after. Maybe on the Cathedral if we get super lucky. And if we get... All we need to do to make that feel better is just get another pill like it. So I might need to quiet up a little bit here as I focus. I'm not going to apologize for that. It's just, you know, it's business. I don't know what our tier effect is here. It's quite a slow fight, though. I think Chubb takes damage from the creep. Is that what's happening there? Or is it my creep because I've taken damage, so I'm creating anemia? I think that is it. There are some red hearts on the ground. The fight's actually going a lot better than I would have expected. Fire, thank you, Bob's Brain. Okay. Good stuff, good stuff. We're actually going to get way more HP than I expected there. And there's no point in using prayer card. Okay. With the god, that's a long way away. Let's hope this is the right direction. I'd like to thank my friends, the Haunts, for choosing to spawn in a pattern where I could not hit them. We seem to have triple shot on the Haunt room a lot. I'm not going to complain about it. Okay, where's my Haunts at? I missed with my Bob's brain. Not that time, though. We could just bomb our way out of these rooms, but I want to go through with them. You know, get red hearts. Who knows, maybe like a golden chest drop or something. We do have four keys now. So every extra key is a surplus. Good. Now, if you want to get technical, I think that this haunt room is actually probably a little bit easier than the last one. At least it'll go a little bit faster, for better or for worse. With bombs, the haunt's not so bad, dog. Especially if those bombs actually stay on the side, the way they're supposed to. Like, three bombs makes him so easy. Which, we just got exactly what we paid for right there. Nice, I was maybe hoping for a little bit more on the red heart side of things, but this cathedral's actually going pretty well, and then all we have to do is get carried on the chest, and this is a big moment. I haven't really thought about the gravitas, you know, the importance of this, this particular run, but this is an important run. If we can beat this as Eve, all we need to do with Eve is get a lamb kill, I think, and then we've sorted her out, and she should be one of the hardest characters in the game to get that stuff done for, so I feel pretty solid about it. Now, we've been carried on the chest many times, but we've also been, I wouldn't say screwed, but not helped on the chest many times as well. Can't really say screwed, because, you know, it's not the chest's fault if it doesn't give us good items. Trying to kind of hold back for Bob's brain here. What the heck? Your weird movements got me all tripping there. I don't even know what that means. What does that mean, okay? People have told me what off the chain means, cream your jeans. Teach me some more parlance here. What is tripping? Is that like in, it's like in Smash Bros when you trip. I know what tripping is, you know, you kind of stumble a little bit. Is that what it is? Like, you got me stumbling? Is it supposed to be a perturbance like in Smash Bros when you trip? And you're like, oh, I hate tripping. Is that the same thing? Am I on the right page at least? Bark twice if you're in Milwaukee. Alright. Isaac fight. I'll just own up to it. I've been doing real bad on Isaac fights lately. I'm hoping that this one's the exception to the rule, but either way, I think we got a very good chance of getting down to the chest. Thank you. Let's do it. We're ready. Oh, we got Fear Shot. Of all the tier effects we could have, this is not the best one, but I think it's okay. Certainly better than having, like, Proptosis or something like that. Something that could actually maybe ruin our run. How have I been taking damage against Isaac lately? Failing to see bullets like those until it's too late. I mean, his shot speed is pretty quick, but still. Okay. Good stuff so far. We're through, like, the first phase. Now, crowd control should be a trickier phase, but that's what I was just about to say. Bob's brain should help us out an maybe an ordinate deal. People, you never use ordinate, right? People always use inordinate. Oh, there's an inordinate amount of tartar on your teeth, Mr. Letourneau. Okay, well, ease up there, dentist. How about, you know, there's an ordinate amount of help here. You know, this has been exactly the way that I anticipated it. That's not a real story from the dentist, by the way. I would have to actually go to the dentist more often to remember their quotes, but usually they tell me that my hygiene routine is sufficient. And you know what? I'm not trying to brag. I'm relatively proud of my dental hygiene. Not necessarily of my teeth, but of my dental hygiene, you know? I floss on the regular. I tongue scrape. If you don't tongue scrape, that shit will change your life. I don't even care about, like, it helping with bad breath or something like that, or reducing the chance of gingivitis. It just feels good. And I'm not talking about using your toothbrush to use a, you know, do a little tongue scrape in there. You know, almost making yourself throw up. You use like a real tongue scraper, get that shit scraped clean. Changed my life, man. Way more fun than flossing. Teach your kids to tongue scrape. This is not necessarily approved by the American Dental Association. I don't know. It might be a complete placebo, but it feels good. Like if I don't tongue scrape, this is so gross, but if I don't tongue scrape for like a few days and then I do it, I'm like, yeah, I noticed a difference. It's a shame because I use this thing called an aura brush, which is like a tongue scraper. And then apparently, like, the CEO was being kind of a dick on Reddit or something like that. People were like, I'll never use that product. And I was like, man. He was, like, astroturfing, which makes my recommendation even funnier. Astroturfing is when you, like, make a fake account or something to say, like, oh, this product's really good, but really it's your product, right? Oh. Well, okay, Toxic Aura is all right. Mysterious Liquid, I should say. Quarter is not very good for us. I am going to take Ludovico Technique. I don't know how it's going to work with Bob's Brain, but look at how it works with Lump of Coal. Like, the tier gets bigger. Oh, snap. Okay. Well, hopefully we can have this kind of bullshit happen a little bit more often. Let's put some bombs down. I really like Ludovico Technique, so I'm not saying no to it, even if it does put us in a bit of a weird spot. You know what? I think we're better off with Yumheart, actually, than Bob's Brain. Anyway. Yeah, the CEO was caught, like, astroturfing on Reddit or something like that. And I was like, that story's actually a real shame. Because I use the Aura Brush. Why didn't you just talk to me? I use Aura Brush, like, you know, 4 or 5 times a week whenever I remember. And I think that product is pretty good. I'm going to turn the music down here, by the way, in just a sec. But don't necessarily consider that an endorsement. Why do I have a tier orbiting my existing tier? Maybe I'll just not complain about that. I'm happy with it. Maybe that's, like, a weird $3 bill thing. Maybe that's It's Guppy's hairball. I don't know. One sec. Music. Options. All right, my apologies there. We don't really need that bomb, let's be honest. So I don't know if Bob's Brain is actually doing anything for us now. Oh my god, when you get, oh it is, when we choose to shoot. When you get, Mom's Contact, it does some pretty good work there, huh? You know, I'll be honest with you, I think this is actually making us do a little bit less damage than we would be if we had tackled this otherwise. But it's kind of fun. I enjoy taking items that other people think are kind of bad that I enjoy. Like Cursed Eye, people hate it. I have never found myself in a position where I've disliked Cursed Eye. But I think it's because I usually just have low HP anyway when I take any item. Samson's Chains. Oh, it's like Spelunky, man. Alright, I saw a post on the subreddit about this item. This is the first time I've ever seen it myself in the wild. I'm pretty excited. I think you can use it to break rocks. I don't actually know what else you could do with it, though. Either way, I'm liking it. Now, I know y'all be liking this shit right here. Samson's C-H-A-I-N-S. Limited mobility right here. Okay, seriously, like, Famine, you should just be straight up deceased. Thank you. Our shot speed is good enough to deal with these guys. And anytime I run into issues with, like, damage, kind of just feeling like we throw some bombs in there. That sorts it out. I would have loved to have gotten some extra bomb synergy on this run. We didn't, but that's okay. Hey, a second quarter. That's kind of ridiculous. Too bad no money equals power has showed up, but hey. I really have no idea what the Samson's Chains are doing, but hey, that's okay. Yeah, if we actually play our cards right, we can get good Bob's Brain hits. Especially against rooms where there's not so many enemies or they're more stationary. That was really dumb, but hey, there's a reason to use Yumheart. It's hard because Bob's Brain gets aimed when we aim our tier. Yeah, but that worked. It also found the secret room. It also did damage me, but we have this bad trip pill. Enemies with high mobility, Ludovico Technique is kind of a problem. So I'm trying to aim Bob's Brain effectively here first. There we go. Then we'll focus on using the Ludovico Technique. Careful, careful. Okay, good stuff. Don't really want to fight Super Greed, but now we don't have a choice. And with $3 bill, Ludovico Technique is pretty sweet. Noticing we're lighting some enemies on fire here. I appreciate that. Almost a very lucky Bob's Brain shot there. Are you really going to give us a third quarter? Here's my third quarter projections. Fuck, this is a lot of money. Really, really do not want to use Bad Trip before our boss fights. If I can avoid using Bad Trip before the boss fight, I will consider it to have been a good life, even if we end up dying. Please don't rush at me. Please, sir, this is very uncouth of you. Oh, Jesus Christ. Well, Anemia is doing a ton of damage, but I don't really love the idea of doing, like, you know, of taking so much damage on a room full of dingles. These guys shouldn't be that hard. No thank you, sir. I'm not interested in your newsletter. I think we have, like, homing tiers on this one. It's a little bit easier to have Ludovico technique aim itself. So I want to kill Sloth last. That's a no-brainer. If we get a Sun card, we pretty much just win the game. That was so bad, but we got a Spirit Heart out of it that we can't even use. I forgot that we have 9 lives as well. So if we lose, we're going way down. All right, Sloth is going to get killed last. I'm not even aiming Ludovico technique. It's being aimed by itself. I mean, slowly, but still. Lover's card. Very useful. Very, very useful. Closing in on a boss room here. Gonna be a little bit late for the subscriber stream today, but that's okay. Should probably let people know. But I didn't expect this run to go as long as it has. This is a bit of an aberration. Oh, Yumheart is ready. Yeah, I think we're gonna be able to do this. And that'll be a nice for our streak. This is indeed the right way. Okay, so Super Lust is annoying. We'll put some bombs down in its way. We could have skipped. No, wait, this is a second secret room. We couldn't have skipped this. Yeah, that was not the best dodging I've ever done. Thank you, though. Let's see what. Oh my god, finally! It's a win. It's a win. Pretty fly. 10 extra bombs. We probably don't need those. What happened to Samson's Chain there? Did you see that? That was great damage on my part. Totally necessary. Feeling pretty good about that. So I'm going to try to be using bombs as much as possible here just to speed this shit up a little bit. Like, Ludovico Technique's already doing its $3 bill thing up in there. Cash rules everything around me. You know the deal. I think it's going to take us probably a long... Oh, if that was a guppy item, I would have laughed so hard. I think it's going to take us a long time to beat Blue Baby. But that's fine. Make sure we're getting Bob's brain in there. Thank you. It's a pain in the ass to have to aim that, but it's all good. Yeah, we're gonna be fine. Blue Baby becomes like a dickhole in a little bit, though. When he starts teleporting like directly into you. That's like the most bullshit move in Rebirth. The enemies like predict where you're gonna be and then teleport directly beside you. That being said, it's you know, it's part of the game. I'll be trying to get used to it here. Are you teleporting away? I guess I don't have to worry. We're not, like, missing out on very many bombs here. We're gonna win this easily, actually. This is a big surprise for me. I did not expect this run to go as well as it did, but it did. And I thank you. You're dead. That was really good. I had a great time on that run, and hey, we unlocked Sacrificial Dagger. The streak is alive here. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed that episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.